Dear students, welcome to computer class of class 6. I hope all of you are maintaining the social distancing to keep yourself, your family as well as the nation free from the deadly coronavirus. So today I am going to start with the second chapter, that is file management organization. Now class 6 chapter 2, the name is file management organization of data. Now first we should know or define the meaning of this term file. Now the word file, a file is a storage place where data or information is stored for future reference. Now it means that a file, it is a place so where I can store the data or information. Like example, school.docx, it is a word file. flower.pptx, it is a PowerPoint file. Now in order to create a file, I should take the help of any application software. It can be MS Word, MS PowerPoint, MS Excel, MS Paint, Logo, or any application. I have to take the help of it in order to create a file. Now I have taken one small example of a file like school.docx. This dot is very, very important, which separates the first name with the extension name. So in a file, if we take a file, so a file, it has two parts, first name and the extension name, separated by a dot. Files. Now the files are classified broadly into three types: ordinary files, directory or folder files, or the special purpose files. Ordinary files means normally the files which you create with the help of MS Word, MS Excel, PowerPoint, Paint, which are made for the normal use. Now folder or the directory or folder file means your files only, any special files which you keep under a folder for future reference. Next comes as the special purpose file. Special purpose files means the files which you get or which are present during the installation of Windows, like auto.exe.bat, then win.exe, then word file, all the important exe files are known as the special purpose files, which are made for special purpose, like maybe for the booting of the computer or the normal function of a computer. Operation means the file which is present in your computer, that different operations or the different functions can be done with the help of it, regarding its access, storing or keeping it in some other place. So different file operations are viewing a file, moving a file, copying a file, deleting a file, playing a file. Now moving, first is viewing a file. Now to view a file which is present in your computer can be done in two ways, like my computer. This my computer icon is present on your desktop, or with the help of Windows Explorer, you will be accessing your local drives, C drive, D drive, F drive, G drive, pen drive, or any other drives where the files can be easily viewed, open, access and stored. Next, moving a file. Moving a file means you will place the file in another new location. Maybe from D drive you want to copy in your pen drive. So there are certain steps are there, and the shortcut keys for the operation is Ctrl plus X and Ctrl plus V. Next, moving a file, copying a file. Copying a file means to make a duplicate copy of a file. Duplicate means as a file will be present in C drive as well as in your D drive. Both copies are there. I can make multiple copies. The steps are there, and the shortcut keys are Ctrl plus C and Ctrl plus V. Next coming as deleting a file. Now, whenever you want to delete a file, can delete means you want to remove it, you cannot access it anymore. So, either by using the del key or using the shift plus del to remove the file permanently. Next is playing a file. Playing a file means like any audio file, video file, you want to listen to the songs or watch a movie. This can be done with the help of VLC media player or Windows media player. Now we'll see all these operations one by one in detail. First one is viewing data from a file. Now, in order to view a data from a file, we have to follow the following steps. First is step one, select and double click the computer icon on the desktop. Now the computer window will appear on the screen, and when the computer window appears, it shows all the drives like C drive, D drive, F drive, any removable drives, all will be shown here. Now in step 2, you will see, suppose you click in your local disk drive D, then it will show you all the files and folders. Then in the step 3, like here in the book they are showing, like you are selecting the result folder, so click on it. Now inside the result folder you have all these sub files are stored. Whichever the folder or whichever the file you feel the best, you double click, that particular one will be open, that is being shown in step 5. Next topic is coming as copying a file. Now main purpose of copying a file means you want to make a multiple copies of it, store it for future reference. And the shortcut keys of it are given in the right hand side knowledge corner, which are important for the exam point of view. Now next is coming as the steps for it. Now the steps for it is to double click on computer icon. In the step 2, you go to the selected drive, select the file, select the option copy, then you go to the source destination, select and double click the destination drive D, then place the pointer in that blank space, right click, you'll see the shortcut menu appears, select the option paste, the file will be pasted to a new location. Next topic is coming as moving a file. Moving a file means you want to create or copy that file in a new location, and the file will be removed from the old location. Now you see the steps for it. Double click on the computer icon on the desktop. Step 2, select and double click the source drive F, and then on the required file, select the file, right click. So if you do the right click, you see one shortcut menu appears, select the option cut, which is highlighted with the light blue color. After that, in step 5, so select and double click on the destination drive D, it will display all the files and folders, keep the pointer in the blank space. Now if you right click, again the shortcut menu will appear, select the option paste, the file will be pasted to a new location. Next is coming as playing audio files. Now to play an audio file, we have to take an application of two. One is Windows Media Player and the VLC Media Player, and below the steps are given. So to play an audio file or an audio CD, follow the steps. So in the step 1, you have to place the CD or the DVD in the drive. Click the Windows Media Player icon present on your desktop. Click the file menu there, and then open, it will display all the drives of the system. Now all of you please look at the figure. So it is showing C drive, D drive, F drive. Now wherever those files are stored or the audio files are stored, click on it. If you click the option step 5, click open, it will display a set of audio files. Now whichever file you feel the best, you select, and finally you click on open button. And now in step 8, finally the audio will be played and you can listen to the beautiful songs and enjoy yourself. Next, the next part is coming as the playing video files. The steps are exactly the same like the previous one, only you have to select the video files as the names are given here. The process is exactly same for the previous one. Now next topic as the function of different buttons present in your any window. If you open, minimize button, maximize button, restoring button and the close button. And I think all of you know the function of this. If you click on the minimize button, means the application will close down in your desktop. Maximizing means what? The size of the window will increase. Now again, if you click on the restoring button, which functions after maximizing button, again the size of your window will decrease. And finally you come to close button, the application will be closed. Next is coming as searching for a file. This is a very important, like suppose a file is present, and dear students, maybe you forget where I have kept the file. Now in order to search a file in your computer, you have to follow the steps. Step 1, click the computer icon that is available on the desktop. The search box appears. Now all of you see the search box in there present, where is written my computer. Now enter the file name to be searched in the system in the search computer box. Step 3, the computer will look for all the files throughout the system and show the results in the window. Now the another important topic coming as searching. Now how can you search with the help of these two operators, which are known as wildcards? One is question mark, another is the asterisk. Now you will say, what is the main or what is the use of these two files? Like suppose you may not know the complete name of a file, or maybe a few alphabets you know. So this can be done easily done with the help of these two characters, that is question mark and asterisk. Now this question mark, so the first wildcard character, which is the question mark, it represents a single missing character. The wildcards represent, the wildcard represents a single character in a file or an extension. It means any character can occupy the position of the question mark. Now in order to perform this, all of you see step 2, enter the file name a*.doc in the, what does this a*.doc means that computer will display all the Word files, Word application file starting with A followed by one character only, like aa.docx, a1.docx files will be displayed. Now all of you see this example given here. Now see is given like apps development, air ticket, so the file starting with A will be displayed. Wildcard character as asterisk, the character represents all the letters in the primary or the secondary name in a file. If the search option is set as lesson*.doc, then it will display all the files starting with the lesson having an extension .doc. This will be more clear with an help. So if you type like lesson*.docx as it is given in your book, so the computer will display all the Word files starting with the word. Last part, we are coming for this exercises, objectives, true and false, fill in the blanks, name the following, then this match the file types with the extension, answer in word, one word answer, short answer questions. Then at the bottom we have the long answer questions. Dear students, please write this, all these question answers, objectives in your book, objectives in your book, question answers in your computer copy, When the school reopens, I will check it. Thank you.